You're on Meet the Press with Treasurer Wayne Swan, and welcome to the panel. Marius Benson, ABC News Radio, and Patricia Cavellis, The Australian. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning, Paul.
The Greens believe the government was bullied into promising a budget surplus by Tony Abbott. It was a brave promise at the time, but now a number of commentators, including former Reserve Bank Board member Professor Warwick McKibben, believe it's too risky. Here he is on Meet the Press last week.
The speed at which you cut the debt really does depend on the state of the economy. A promise 3 years ago to cut by next financial year, clearly at the time, if it was the correct decision, is not the correct decision now because so many things have changed.
Mr. Swan, leading economists think the government's political obsession with delivering a surplus in the coming week is basically politically risky. Are you risking slowing the economy?
It's the correct economic thing to do. Just think about it. We've got growth returning to trend. We've got unemployment at 5.2%. We've got solid consumption in our economy. We've got a very strong investment pipeline. All of those things mean that domestically it's entirely appropriate to return our budget to surplus. But also, I think when you look at what's going on internationally, it's even more important as well. I mean, we've seen the British economy go back into recession. We've seen unemployment in Spain hit something like 25%. You see, in these times of global uncertainty, fiscal credibility is really important. It's more important than ever. And for all of those reasons, the strength of our domestic economy, what is going on internationally, the opportunity to give maximum flexibility to the Reserve Bank, all of those things mean it's entirely appropriate in economic terms to bring the budget back to surplus.
And Treasurer, the Reserve Bank is meeting on Tuesday to consider rates. Do you expect this to be the first of a series of rate cuts?
Well, that's entirely a matter for the Independent Reserve Bank. People can have a look at their minutes.
You've certainly been putting a lot of pressure on them, though. On this, you keep talking about the flexibility you're giving them. Does that mean that you expect them to cut rates?
No, what it means is that we are implementing fiscal policy which gives the Reserve Bank room to move should it desire to do so, and that is entirely appropriate. You see, some years ago, in the face of the global financial crisis, monetary policy and fiscal policy was expansionary. But of course, global growth is now back to around trend and growth is returning to trend domestically. Those two things mean here in Australia, it's entirely appropriate to bring our budget back to surplus and to ensure that the government is not contributing to price pressures in the economy and giving the Reserve Bank flexibility to cut rates should it desire to do so.
Mr. Swan, you said there'll be some pain in the budget, and you've actually specified that some of that pain will be felt by better-off Australians in the area of superannuation. At the moment, if you're earning $300,000, you can cut your tax, which you'd be paying at 45%. In super, you're paying 15%. That's going to be increased from 15% to 30%. Still a tax cut for those people, but not as much. That's your intention?
Well, we think it's very important to ensure that superannuation tax concessions are targeted appropriately, and it is the case that people on very high incomes get a very big benefit compared to people on average incomes. So the government is determined to have a look at the distribution of these concessions. We're very committed to superannuation. We're going to increase the superannuation guarantee from 9 to 12. That's very important to build up our national savings. But as we go about doing that, we've got to make sure that the superannuation concessions are distributed fairly around the system. And in a budget where we are looking for savings, it's important to run your ruler over a whole range of tax expenditures to make sure that they are directed in the right areas.
But in the cut to the people earning over $300,000, a significant effect on them, but you only get about $1 billion out of it. Is it worth it?
Well, I think it's very important that everybody out there has confidence that the distribution of tax concessions has a degree of equity and fairness about it. And I think that's entirely a reasonable thing to do.
So, Mr. Swan, so far all of the authorised government leaks on the budget have been about hitting the rich. But at the same time, you've sent the message that the pain of this budget should be spread equally. Should we expect that there'll be some hit to middle-income earners and lower-income earners?
Well, we will in the budget demonstrate quite significant restraint across a whole number of areas of expenditure. But Patricia, you'll just have to wait until budget night to see the full document. I can't be announcing it all
but
here
so
this morning.
So far you've told us about that the rich end. I'm just wondering if you can tell people today whether we should expect more pain at the middle income level.
No, I think people will have to be a little patient and wait for budget night. Coming back to surplus is a very important economic objective, as I've said before. I've also made the point very clearly that we will do everything within our power to protect low and middle income earners, and that's what we will do. But the full detail will be there on the night. I can't announce it all and meet the press this morning.
A pity about that. Well, a key number on the floor of the Parliament, of course, is Andrew Wilkie. He says he's keeping his powder dry, waiting to see how crucial his vote becomes. His ally, Nick Xenophon, sees it this way.
The reason why Peter Slipper is in the Speaker's chair is because Labor wanted to sideline Andrew Wilkie when it comes to poker machine reform.
Mr Swan, Andrew Wilkie himself has echoed that sentiment from Nick Xenophon this morning, saying that Peter Slipper was only put in the chair to marginalise him. He feels let down by the Prime Minister. Are those perceptions from Nick Xenophon and Andrew Wilkie accurate?
No, they're not. I don't accept those characterisations at all. The government has a very significant commitment to deal with the problem, to deal with problem gambling, and we have been working on a very important package, and we've been talking to Mr Wilkie about that package. I think he's indicated this morning that he is studying a number of elements of the package that we've developed. We're very keen to deal with problem gambling, but we have to do it in a way which passes the Parliament.
Well, if it wasn't to neutralise Andrew Wilkie, why did you put Peter Slipper in the chair, and are you feeling a bit sorry that you did it now?
Well, I think he has been a very good speaker, but all these other issues have arisen in the meantime. He's done the right thing to step aside, but I think we should let the processes work their way through the system. And in terms of what he may do in the future, that's entirely a matter for Mr Slipper and entirely a matter for the Parliament.
Mr Swan, another issue that's going to cloud the government today is the Craig Thomson moving to the crossbench to leave the Labor Party. Now, you are Deputy Prime Minister. I assume you're privy to these decisions. Has that been Craig Thomson's decision to leave, or is it Julia Gillard's decision?
Well, as I said earlier, I think we should wait for Mr Thomson to make his statement, and I've also indicated the Prime Minister will be making a statement later in the day. I don't propose to add anything to that.
Will it make it harder for you to pass your budget, or do you have a guarantee that Craig Thomson will still vote for you for your proposals?
Patricia, I think we have had a lot of success in legislating in this Parliament, and our budget last year went through in record time. As I've been talking about already this morning, very important to bring our budget back to surplus, very important given global economic instability to send a message about our strong economic fundamentals to the world. I would say to the crossbenchers, as I would say to the Liberal Party itself, that what we do need is strong support for a strong economic framework, an economic framework with rigour that will be in this budget, because it's so essential to our future economic prosperity and to the hopes and aspirations of millions of Australians. So I wouldn't necessarily want to see the Liberal Party playing the sort of politics with this budget that they've played in the past.
Well, thank you very much for being with us this morning, Treasurer Wayne Swan.
Thank you.
And coming up, small business has big ambitions for the budget. Peter Strong joins us. Cartoonist Nicholson and The Australian thinks the Prime Minister is slipping back into the Wilkie gambling reforms.
I'm coming round, Mr. Wilkie. Gambling is a terrible vice.